Woo! Y'all ain't know her, right?
Love that on that beat.
Let's go! No masterpiece.
Welcome back to another episode of We Are Gonna Fix Your Technique today with Functional Bodybuilding Principles. That's right, we're talking about the deadlift, the conventional deadlift, or perhaps just hinging in general. So hinging with holding a load below your waist. Deadlifting is a challenging movement. The brain activity of learning how to hinge at the hips and not flex your spine or not overemphasize and utilize your legs is something that takes clients, athletes, a long time to develop. And sometimes it's because people try and fast track and they get too quickly into conventional pulling off the floor without going through some necessary brain development steps early on. So here's a way that we approach this within our Revival Strength coaching principles, programs, and with our individual clients. First and foremost, I really like to teach a top-down deadlift or a top-down RDL, Romanian deadlift, as a first step in hinging once we start to introduce load. Why? Well, as you're seeing in the top-down RDL, I'm taking the barbell out of the rack from about waist height. What that allows me to do is it allows me to pick up the load with my spine stacked tall in a good position. When the barbell is on the ground and you have to bend over to grab it, oftentimes people will load their spine incorrectly, and once that loading has happened, it's very difficult to achieve good positions for the repetitions that follow. So with a top-down approach, what we can do is we can load in a good position, and then we can train ranges of motion that are 1/4 of the way down, 1/2 the way down, 3/4 of the way down. You can train a lot of different ranges of motion and essentially find what is your optimal range that allows you to hold good mechanics and a good spinal position in the RDL. The RDL also is a great tool to emphasize the hinge at the hip and de-emphasize the knee bend. So notice when I'm doing the top-down RDL, my knees aren't bending too much. There's a slight hinge there, but really most of the hinging is happening at my waist. Once you've kind of worked your way into a full range of motion top-down RDL, then I think you're ready for the next progression, which is an RNT RDL. So this is where the barbell is going to be loaded on the floor, and you're going to place a band around your waist, and that band is going to be providing some tension back behind you. That band is essentially there to create some neuromuscular connection that is just a feedback loop to get you to really engage your glutes, and to know that as you hinge down to go pick up that bar, you're gonna drive your hips back behind you in the same direction that you're being pulled by the band. So RNT, Romanian deadlifts, where the loading starts on the floor, another great tool to help progress from a top-down RDL into pulling off the floor. Okay, we're ready to graduate from that, and we wanna start learning full range of motion, deadlifting or pulling. And so what we can do for that is we can start to put the weight onto lifting blocks. So if you're gonna move into a conventional deadlift and you wanna start loading a little bit heavier, you could pick 12-inch or 6-inch blocks. This is gonna shorten the range of motion. Shortening the range of motion is useful for individuals that are still, again, learning the motor control of a proper deadlift. Maybe they are lacking some range of motion in their hip flexion. Maybe they have really tight hamstrings or some part of their kinetic chain is a little bit off and doesn't allow them to get in an optimal position at the bottom. Building some resilience and some strength from a height of 6 inches above where you would normally pull or 12 inches from above where you would normally pull is a great way to progress people, and those blocks can get lower and lower and lower. After you've done some pulling off of blocks, another approach to progress towards a full conventional deadlift would be learning how to pull in a sumo stance. By pulling in a sumo stance, you're gonna shorten the range of motion a little bit, which essentially does something similar to what pulling off blocks does. It also puts your hips into a wider stance and a wider position. By moving your feet out, it can make it a lot easier for individuals to get a much cleaner hinge at the hip and be less inhibited by posterior chain tightness or hamstring tightness. So if you follow these steps of a top-down RDL into an RNT RDL, into pulling from blocks and then a sumo deadlift, you should be able to progress and be ready for conventional pulling. Conventional pulling is when your feet are just inside your hands. Remember, we're trying to maintain great lumbar and thoracic spinal position as we hinge at the hip, not over rely on our knees to do the flexion and the standing up for us. I hope these tips help you. Be prepared to regress back some ways. Spend some time there fixing some of these mechanical pieces that you may have in your deadlift. And when you pull next off the floor, I hope you're stronger than ever. If you like this, tag somebody, comment below, and we'll see you next time.